Here's a bee. On its own, it can collect nectar, but that's about it. Now add thousands of bees, and suddenly they're making honey. They're cooling the hive and defending it. That's exactly how multi-agent systems work. Many simple AI agents, each with a small job, coming together to solve big, complex problems. At its core, an AI agent is an autonomous system that can perform tasks on behalf of another agent or another system by designing its workflow and using available tools. And the performance of AI agents depends on the large language model, or LLM, used to power them, as well as their set of tools. And of course, a reasoning framework that dictates how they take the output of these tools to make decisions. Multi-agent systems take this a step further by allowing agents to remain autonomous, but also cooperate and coordinate in agent structures. What do these structures look like? Let's start with a decentralized network. Let's imagine you have several AI agents. Each of them can communicate with one another to share information and resources to help inform their decision process, each operating with the same amount of authority. This is often referred to as an agent network. There are also hierarchical structures, which are tree-like, and they contain agents with varying levels of autonomy. The simplest example is a simple or supervisor hierarchical structure, in which one agent has the decision-making authority over other agents. And by adding more layers and more subtrees, we can make the system more complex. There are many ways to distribute the authority here. For example, in uniform hierarchical structures, all agents at the same level play the same role and have the same authority. And the agents coordinate laterally, meaning at the top of the structure, you might have a single manager or a coordinator agent. And in the middle levels, there are supervisor agents, each managing a group of agents below them. And at the bottom, these are the worker agents, so they're directly performing the tasks. And this structure helps break down responsibilities. So higher levels coordinate, lower levels execute. Let's keep in mind, though, that the authority doesn't have to be strictly top-down or centralized. It can also be distributed across sub-hierarchies, in which one agent has the decision-making authority over other agents. Or maybe we want the structure to be dynamic, so that the authority shifts based on agent expertise or on a situational basis. Now that we've covered the basics, let's talk about implementing these agents in the real world. What are the advantages of using multi-agent systems over a single agent? Well, to start, they provide us with flexibility. This is because multi-agent systems can adjust to varying environments by adding, removing, or adapting agents. Multi-agent systems also allow for scalability. The cooperation of several agents implies a greater pool of shared information. And this collaboration allows these systems to solve more complex problems than a single agent could. These systems also encourage domain specialization. In a single agent structure, one agent performs tasks in various domains, whereas each agent in a multi-agent system can hold specific domain expertise. Perhaps one agent specializes in synthesizing research papers, the other performs complex calculations, and another specializes in web search via an API. The last advantage I want to emphasize here is that, believe it or not, multi-agent systems outperform single agents. And this is because the more action plans that are available to an agent, the more learning and reflection occur. An AI agent incorporating knowledge and feedback from other agents allows for a greater magnitude of information synthesis. And of course, as with most things in life, there are some challenges with building multi-agent systems. When they're built using the same LLMs, for example, they can experience shared pitfalls and agent malfunctions. Such weaknesses might cause a system-wide failure of all involved agents or expose vulnerability to adverse attacks. Our choice of the LLM, among other factors, impacts how effectively an agent performs. And this is why thorough training, testing, and data governance are critical to minimizing failures. Another challenge of building multi-agent systems is coordination complexity. As developers, we're tasked with enabling coordination and negotiation between agents so that they're not competing with resources or simply overriding each other's outputs. Instead, agents need mechanisms to share information, resolve conflicts, and synchronize decisions in a way that maximizes the collective performance rather than causing bottlenecks or contradictions. And the last challenge we'll touch on here is the risk of unpredictable behavior. Though this drawback in and of itself isn't unique to multi-agent systems, it can easily be amplified. Typically, the more agents are involved, the greater the unpredictable behavior becomes. All right, now if we want to avoid having too many cooks in the kitchen, when is it best to stick to a single-agent system versus a multi-agent system? Well, it depends on the task and our objectives, right? If the problem is complex, and perhaps it spans various domains. Maybe it has limited resources. Or it needs to scale across changing environments. This is exactly when a multi-agent system truly shines. If we want to build on this restaurant analogy of cooks in the kitchen, for example, let's put it this way. One chef is completely fine for a small kitchen, right? Think of it like making breakfast for yourself. But if you're running a restaurant that serves different cuisines and desserts, etc., you'll want the whole kitchen staff working in sync. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have questions or comments, let me know below. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe for more content like this.